come under the star. We will pray for purification through the inflow of God's love. May we send forth from the center of our being as one brotherhood, rays of love and wisdom towards humanity and all living creatures. And as we radiate God's love, may we be caught up in the power of the spiritual worlds, and may our vision clear and the wisdom of the ages be unfolded before us. Thus may we meet for God's work, to serve him and creation.
Light this small light within our midst. It gives us the reminder to, as Jane just read in the prayer, to radiate God's love, to send out that light to all in need, to all the corners of the earth in need, doing everything we can. Will you please join me in the Lodge invocation? May the light of Christ shine in my heart, stand guard over my thoughts, and guide my speech and actions into the ways of service. May the light of Christ shine from my heart, to heal the sick in mind and body, to comfort the bereaved, to sustain the weary. May the light of Christ illumine my understanding, and the understanding of all, bringing through vision and awareness of the eternal life and of the Christ within us all. Amen. Time we join together in prayer. We remember the great need of our world, and we seek to still our mind so that we come into a place of peace and deep stillness, drawing closer to God in prayer. Let us open our hearts to the power, love, and wisdom of God,
Christ, light, and love in our hearts, we call to the great angels of the Christ Star Circle. Being still, we feel their presence and their power. And now, with all the will of our minds, with all the love of our deepest hearts, we send forth the light. We send it forth as a great star of light, a blazing star, a star of the Christ light, lifting all hearts into the eternal heart of God. By all the power of Christ within our hearts, we send forth the light to the world. We hold our beautiful planet in the healing light of the Christ star. We hold within this healing ray the soil, the waters of the earth, and the air, and all nature, especially the human and animal kingdoms. We hold in the heart of the Christ star the soul of the Americas, the soul of the people of the Americas. May the light of the Christ star shine through the hearts and minds of the people of the Americas to bring healing to mankind and reverence for all life. Let us hold within this great healing star anyone known to us personally who is in need of help or healing. Silently, we name them now. And see them radiant within this beautiful healing light. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, let us open our hearts to the Christ power, wisdom, and love, and together we call upon the angels of healing angels of the Christ star circle to draw close. We come into the soft radiance of this love as we focus and hold the healing light of the Christ star over our world. In the soul of humanity, all growing through this deep change on planet Earth for our evolutionary journey. And particularly, we also focus this light on the children of our world, in the animal kingdom, so very sensitive to change of any kind. We see them enfolded by the angels of healing, Divine Mother, in her divine love. And with hearts full of gratitude, we give our grateful thanks. Amen. Today, Jeff has selected a wonderful reading from some extracts from our teaching that is hopefully everyone will find very helpful and practical on our journey together. Strive to put into practice the precept of love, cooperation, and unity. Be quiet, be silent when there's controversy. Pour upon controversy the oil of peace. This is the work of every brother, to pour the oil of peace on troubled waters. You do not need self-assertion. All that is needed is the oil of peace and love, because that eases the wheels, the machinery of love. Machinery runs more smoothly when it is oiled. This simple message has a great value to you, dear brethren, in your inner work and in your work in the outside world. Always work for harmony. Always oil the wheels. Never incite friction. This is not God's way. The law of God is love, cooperation, and brotherhood. God is love. God loves all. God is love. And you are part of God. Be loving. Be gentle. There is no higher gospel, no pure gospel than the gospel of love. Remember always to feel the light of Christ in your heart and look for the best. Never condemn. Remember that every soul has to learn to recognize God in every form of life. You call life good and bad, but you will learn that all of life is one, and what appears to be bad and on what you earth call evil is really the life of God evolving and causing all that is good to rise to the surface. Think of that, my children, and balance what appear to be good and evil, for both are part of life. Both have their part to play in the growth, in the evolution, and in the salvation of every living thing. Keep on keeping on, and never give up. Keep on keeping on, and you will get there. You will get there. The Master listens to your thoughts, and each one of you vibrates thought. And thought is the most powerful agent in the life. Life is the result of thought, and as a man thinketh, so he is. Humanity is born onto this earth planet by God's thought and God's love for his children, for the little ones, the little sparks of his own life. And as your children are born of your love, so all mankind comprises a great family of Father, Mother, God. Therefore, think of yourselves as compassionate and tenderly understanding of your brother. There is so much confusion on earth, but you as an individual can do so much to help humanity. You can do so much by being right with God, right with your fellows. Let a man set his own house in order, and then you will no longer judge others. Get yourself right, right with God, and put into operation the law of unity and harmony. And in this way, you will help your country, and you will help all peoples. We see a bright light at the end of the dark tunnel, and it is coming nearer to you, or you may be getting nearer to the light. Be kind to one another. Be kind to all men and women. Just be kind, and you will increase the power of God in your own being. What you call miracles are really natural happenings, by God's will working through man. What appears to be a miracle is only the law of God operating through physical matter, and yet not understood by human beings. Nevertheless, you're all moving forward on the path of the realization of your potentialities. And when you're ready and right with God, God will do the work through you and your fellow beings. Man can learn his lesson through pain or joy. The choice is his. May you all choose God's way, and you will be led to perfect harmony and complete happiness. And our last words are, be patient with all people, but above all, be patient with yourself. We notice that you all become impatient with yourself. Don't do that. Be patient with yourself as you would be patient with your brothers, those with whom you live and work. Be patient with yourself, patient in your development, and don't try to rush forward. Oh, my dear ones, the ancient teaching is, that if a soul rushes forward, it comes against a sharp instrument, which pierces the heart, and then you're sad, you're grieved, and you're hurt. So remember patience. Patience in your development, with your fellow beings, and patient with yourself. And then you will find a glow of joy and happiness, which will carry you forward on the path of your development. You can only grow with patience by not rushing forward. Look at a little seed in the earth, the plant, the sapling. It grows quietly and patiently with that love from the Heavenly Father, the beginning, the one Adam. Seek ye first the kingdom of the heart, the kingdom of heaven. Harmony, love, tolerance, gentleness, and peace. Amen.
Please join us for our second hymn, number 28, Lord, Thy Glory Fills the Heaven, number 28.
Holy, 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 singing, Lord of hosts, our Lord.
decided to call this one Dealing with Everything. The words of White Eagle, and many others, of course, can help us in our daily interactions with others. Think of the others involved above yourself. Act with love in your heart. And perhaps one of the best things to do, if you don't know or aren't exactly sure what to do, don't do anything right away. After all, hasty responses are often regretted. They may not have been our thought-out choice. They may not have been kind, true, and helpful. Or, as Buddha warned, kind, true, and necessary. In fact, they might have been a reaction instead of a response. As a teacher in nearly constant contact with teenagers, it is very evident to me how a single poorly chosen or well-chosen word can instantly alter someone's mood, attitude, and behavior, sometimes with lasting effects. Maya Angelou said it very well. I've learned that people will forget what you've said. People will forget what you did. But people will never forget how you made them feel. We should always take care with our words. We should choose them carefully, much more carefully than we do most of the time. After all, we may be eating them. They ought to taste good. If it isn't kind, true, and helpful, you probably shouldn't say it. And that is a lot to process prior to everything you say or every decision you have to make. Allow me to read some paragraphs from The Quiet Mind, White Eagle's bestseller, if you will, all chosen to address how we might deal with both people and problems. If the action of another irritates you, and you chafe under a sense of injustice, do not try to attack, even in your thoughts, the one who appears to have offended. Have you not given yourself to the master of love? There can be no compromise. Your way is clearly shown. It is the way of love, gentleness, and peace. Cast your burden upon the Lord. In other words, let go. Lay down your problems. Do not try to unravel the knot, which gets tighter and tighter as you pull at it. Lay it down. Concentrate all your heart upon that gentle, loving personality, the Lord Jesus Christ, and all knots will be loosened, all problems solved. Love is the great solvent of all difficulties, all problems, all misunderstandings. Apply love by your inner attitude towards any human problem. Put aside your reasoning mind. Let divine love operate in you. Give from your inner self God's love, and you will be surprised to find that every problem will be solved. The wise man does not argue. He remains silent and goes quietly on his path, concerned only with learning to follow in the footsteps of his master. Understand that you yourselves must work in your everyday life. It is your reactions to daily events and to the conditions of life that really bring about attunement and achievement. It is no good listening to White Eagle or any other teacher unless you yourself work for self-mastery. The beginning of this work is your awareness of the still, small voice within, of that gradually increasing light in you which causes you to react as a gentle brother to all the conditions and all the circumstances of life. Be gentle with yourself. Jesus said, "Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself." This does not mean selfishness. It means kindness to yourself because you are God's child. Give opportunities in your daily life for the Christ within to manifest itself. This is what we mean by loving yourself. Love peace of mind, love doing the right thing, love living according to divine law. And how, you ask, are we to walk the spiritual path? We answer, say little, love much, give all, judge no man, aspire to all that is pure and good, and keep on keeping on. You must learn to act, so to live each day that you are naturally, at all times, a being of love. Love is not sentimentality. Love is seeing good, seeing God, recognizing the divine law of cause and effect working throughout all life. To love is to be tolerant towards all men, towards all the happenings of daily life. To be patient, thoughtful, kind, and meek. All these qualities are contained in the one word, love. Worth remembering. I have another old bit to finish with today, one that I shared quite a while ago, and I think is very powerful, and it meshes perfectly with all of this. This year we didn't have a normal high school graduation, and it made me think back to our first ceremony 15 years ago. The last speaker of that evening was a senior who gave the invocation. It included this legend. An elder Cherokee was teaching his grandchildren about life. He said to them, "A fight is going on inside me. It is a terrible fight, and it is between two wolves. One wolf represents fear, anger, envy, sorrow, regret, greed, arrogance, self-pity, guilt, resentment, inferiority, lies, false pride, superiority, and ego. The other stands for joy, peace, love, hope, sharing, serenity, humility, kindness, benevolence, friendship, empathy, generosity, truth, compassion, and faith. This same fight is going on inside you and inside every other person, too." The children thought about it for a minute, and then one child asked his grandfather, "Which wolf will win?" The old Cherokee simply replied, "The one you feed." This legend describes a list of good traits and not good traits. The legend implies that the good person, the person who has figured out what this fight is all about, will be the one who knows how to feed the good wolf. Both the reading and those bits from the Quiet Mind are full of words supporting the good wolf side. Look for the best. Never condemn. Be loving, gentle. Be patient with all people, above all with yourself. Be kind. Be compassionate. Winning this battle inside us means making the right decisions. It means choosing correctly, no matter what the situation. Making choices that are kind, truthful, and helpful. If what you say to someone is neither kind, true, nor helpful, why say it? You're putting yourself on the wrong side. If what you do in a situation puts others first and is done with love for the others involved, you've chosen the right side. You've fed the right wolf. Feeding time, decision time, comes upon us sometimes without warning, with no time to think, "What should I do?" When you have to make an decision, what do you do? When you have to make an emotional decision or response, what do you do? Remembering the words of these wise ones, from Jesus and Buddha to White Eagle to the Cherokee Elder and Maya Angelou, can allow us to step back, figuratively speaking, and reassess the situation, taking the big picture into account, not just the single stimulus we are reacting to. It lets our minds prepare a more thoughtful solution. In essence, it allows us to remember which wolf to feed.
Now, as we come together for our communion today, just feel yourself relaxing, breathe deeply and comfortably, as the crystal ball will be helping us to move into our inner journey, our communion with Father, Mother, God. Provide us with strength for our journey and to send us ever-sustaining love. As we begin, we feel this place of stillness, calm and peace. For you, it may be a quiet glade, a sandy beach, a secluded pond, a sweeping mountain vista, a place of openness, and yet perfect solitude. We are alone and yet surrounded by this beautiful golden light as we all become aware of the presence of Christ radiating his love and his beautiful golden essence to each one, whether they're here physically in the temple or feel that beautiful golden radiance permeating every cell of your being. And now, the Christ offers sustenance in the form of spiritual bread and wine. Take this. Feel it as comforting as a soft blanket of love. And be thankful. Be restored and be strengthened for our days ahead and our ever-growing journey to the Christ consciousness. Divine love enfolds us all. And be at peace. And now, very gently, Christ begins to fade from our inner vision, moving to a beautiful orb of light, always with us. He gently withdraws from our presence, but the gentle golden light and the feeling of his love remains with each one of us, helping remind us be all love.